welcome back to yet another interesting video in the Paper 1 revision series of arpitakarwa.com. I know that exam is right around the corner and most of you are extremely worried about how to complete or how to at least deal with the topics of UGC NET Paper 1. And one of the most important topic that you feel like killing is government and higher education, because I'm pretty sure that most of you are like me. So we are not in touch with the current affairs, neither we feel like reading about the legislation and the judiciary and the executive bodies of government. Also, we kind of are revising paper 2 so much that we are not getting enough time to study paper 1, and specifically to study so much about government and higher education. So don't worry if you are having these questions in your mind and if you are dead serious about completing the monster like unit government and higher education, because in this video I'm going to give you a very simple plan. I'm going to exactly tell you what to study and what to skip if you want to score highest with the limited time and energy that you have. So if that's the case with you and that's what excites you, keep watching this video till the end, because I'm going to share some of the most valuable information which will help you to increase your score for the upcoming NET exam. So make sure that you don't waste your time and energy reading all those pages in those guidebooks or maybe notes that you have taken from your friend. You stick to what I'm telling you in this video and just try to go through the previous year papers, and I'm pretty sure that you'll be amazed to see that out of 5, you can very easily solve 3 questions. So rather than looking at what to study, let me first calm you down and reduce the baggage by telling you what not to study. So, as you all must be aware of the fact that the syllabus of UGC NET Paper 1 was slightly changed last year, and when the syllabus got changed, I saw that there was a change in the paper pattern, specifically when we talk about the unit government and higher education. So earlier they were concentrating more on the constitution and the government part, so they were taking up questions from fundamental duties, fundamental rights, what are the roles and duties of Prime Minister, how the President helps in the assistance of the government. Then there were questions on different rights and different models, for example, Legislative Assembly, Election Commissioner, and so many things. Now, since the time that the syllabus has changed, I've seen that they have inclined more towards higher education. So if you are running short of time, a very good decision would be to skip the government section and focus more on the higher education section. I'm going to cover this in detail in this video also, but for now just understand the fact that you don't need to give a lot of time in learning the government bodies and their roles and functions. The second important thing that you can skip at this moment is the education system of India and how it has developed all the year long. There have been a lot of commissions that started since the time Britishers left our country. We have Macaulay's Minute, we have Wood's Dispatch, we have Radhakrishnan Commission. All these questions can be asked in exam, but then the chances of these questions occurring in paper 1 is very less. If you are preparing for UGC NET paper 2, then don't forget to watch my video on English in India, wherein I have explained the entire English in India section, which talks about the development of higher education and English as a subject in India. So you'll more likely to have these questions in paper 2 English literature rather than paper 1 general paper. So make sure that you can skip all the transaction topics, for example, how education system evolved. You can skip that. Another thing that you can skip altogether is the state and the local bodies. For example, Panchayati Raj, or maybe the role and duty of Chief Minister. They have never asked it. And when I was going through the most important books that are in market for UGC NET Paper 1, I found that they are putting up a lot of emphasis on the local and the state bodies, which is irrelevant from NET point of view. So these are the 3 topics which you can very easily skip and not lose out on the marks. Now that we have tackled what to not study, let us divert and look at what to study and what's there in our basket. The first important topic from which you can expect a lot of questions is the topic of the higher education bodies. We all know that there are so many government bodies involved in higher education. For example, UGC, University Grants Commission, which is a statutory body started in 1956. Then we have NAAC, N-A-A-C, which stands for National Assessment and Accreditation Council. Then we have NAC, National Advisory Council. So you must know the full names of these bodies. Also, you must know what are their duties and responsibilities, because I've seen that they at least ask one question from any of these bodies. They might ask you that, okay, which of these statements are true about UGC? They'll give you four statements and you have to choose the correct statements. The same thing they can do for NAAC, or they can do for NTA, now that NTA is also involved in higher education, conducting all these important examinations. So make sure that you make small notes for all these topics, and also go back to the previous year papers and see if you can answer the questions that have been asked there. After looking at the higher education bodies, it is important to look at the important universities. They ask a lot of questions from the important universities, and you need to also keep yourself updated about which university has won some awards this year. For example, in 2017, in both June and December, they asked two questions. In one of the papers, they asked us that which college is known as the best college of 2017, and the college was Miranda House in Delhi. Then again they asked a question that which university has been given visitors award, and the university name was Jawaharlal Nehru University, Delhi. Also, you must be aware of the important terms like what are deemed universities, what is a meta university, and which universities have adopted the meta university concept. Also, there have been questions asking us about which state has maximum number of fake universities. Okay, so you can see how they are some or the other way asking us about the good universities or the bad universities, or they are asking us about concepts related to universities. So make sure you acquaint yourself to these concepts. You make small notes for the same, so that just before the day of the exam, you can go through these notes and you can quickly revise the topics. The third important topic which you must cover is the basic concepts about higher education. Now, I would rather say that these are common sense based questions, but there's no harm if you can just read something about these topics. For example, they every year ask at least one question talking about either online education, or maybe they can ask you about distance education, they can ask you about higher education. They might ask you that what problems that higher education in India has faced because of globalization, and you'll be given four options. So these are common sense based questions. You can apply your brain on the day of the exam and get that solved, but there's no harm to read something about the same so that you don't feel nervous on the day of the exam. Also, MOOC, that is Mass Open Online Courses, you might get questions related to that. These are some basic and new features that are coming up every year. They might also ask you a question based on value education. How to integrate values in a kid? What do you think would be the best ways? Four options would be given to you. So these are common sense based basic questions, but still I would suggest you to at least prepare some notes on the same. So if we summarize, I've given you three important things that you have to study if you want to get good marks in the higher education sector. The first one deals with knowing the important government bodies involved in higher education. The second one deals with knowing the important universities and colleges. And the third one, of course, deals with the basic facts and basic terminology. So you must be aware of the latest happenings and also about the major trends. For example, higher education, distance education, online learning, value education. You must know about these terms. So with that note, I would like to end this video. I hope that with this video, you got more clarity on what to study at this last moment so that you can get those extra marks. If you have any other questions, any other doubts, feel free to put that in the comment section below. Also, at least once visit my website arpitakarwa.com so that you know what all things you need to keep in mind while you're preparing for UGC NET English Literature. at the same time, my request would be if you can follow me on all the social media platforms so that you get notified about all the latest happenings which occurs in the field of higher education. So with that note, I would like to take your leave. That's it for this video lecture. We'll meet very soon in the next video lecture. Till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature, and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.